Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Cold Coffee. Let's go and check out the birthdays. Now with Dominic Dufour and Ines Garcia, let's go and check out the news.
Welcome to the Daily Dose,
your source to the latest updates.
This week, top updates.
Philadelphia City Council has passed a bill banning police use of tear gas, rubber bullets, and pepper spray during protests or other First Amendment protected activities. In response to the ongoing protests in Philadelphia, Walmart has also announced they're removing firearms and ammunition off some sale floors as a precaution.
Governor Enrique Alfaro said Wednesday morning that his government had taken the decision to press the emergency button due to a recent spike in infections. Non-essential economic, social, religious, and sports activities will be permitted between 6 a.m. and 7 p.m., but suspended outside those hours between October 30th and November 13th. Non-essential activities will be suspended entirely on Saturdays and Sundays.
At least 140 migrants have drowned off the coast of Senegal in the deadliest recorded shipwreck this year. The vessel was carrying about 200 people on their way from Senegalese town of Embor to Spain's Canary Islands.
The Day of the Dead in Mexico is usually celebrated by the orange color of the cempasúchil flower, decorated streets, houses, cemeteries, and traditional altars. The restrictions imposed to stop the spread of the coronavirus will keep people in their homes and many cemeteries will remain closed.
Let's see what Karime has for us on the sports section.
Hello, Cold Coffee, welcome back. This is Karime, and for today's sports section, I asked a friend of mine who is a Division I soccer player at the University of Oklahoma to film how a day in her life looks like. Let's go check it out.
Let's see what generation wins this week on Generation Points. That was it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed and we see you next time. Goodbye.